Good morning. Today we will study engine geology, and under engine geology we study rock excavation, rock characteristics, investigation, rock handling, tunneling, drill bits, drill equipments and drill patterns and detonators. So under the topic of rock excavation, first we should know what are the rock characteristics for the rock. We will excavate the characteristics of the various rocks. First rock, igneous. Igneous rocks are rocks which were formed when the magma comes out through the volcanoes and flow on the surface of the earth as lava. And on the deposition of lava, we get the igneous rock. Granite and basalt are the examples of the igneous rock. Next is sedimentary rock. Sedimentary rocks are formed after layer by layer deposition of the sediments under the water bed and through the weathering actions, erosion etc. And that those rocks are named as sedimentary rocks. The examples, primary examples of sedimentary rocks are sandstone, shale and limestone. Metamorphic rocks are the rocks which were rocks which are formed from the igneous rock and sedimentary rock upon the excess pressure and heat deep beneath the surface of earth crust of the, and that earth crust, the distance, the depth should be beyond 5 kilometers. These metamorphoses originated as igneous and sedimentary, but changed by heat and pressure and chemical reactions and crystallizations. So examples of the metamorphic rocks are slate, marble, schist. Now these the rocks were defined by their hardness on the Mohs scale, and that scale starts from 1 to 10. Under Mohs scale, 1 is given as talc, which we also talcum powder, and 10 is of diamond. Now what are the difficulties we face during excavation of the rocks? First, we should know the type of the rock, which type of rock it is. Second, extent of the fractures, how many fractures. We should be able to identify the extent of the fractures which is in the subject rock. Then other planes of weakness, are there planes of weakness? We can see the planes of weakness, we must notice those and write it down. Next is amount of weathering, comma predominant grain. So we must also see whether how much amount of weathering has been done in the past, in the geological past of the rock, and which predominant grain it has. Means grain, for example, if it is a limestone, it should have calcium grain. So calcium depositions and limestone grains. So this grain predominant, which type of the grain defines the type of the rock. Next, the size. We must know, we must see the size of the the rock which we will excavate. And the last is brittleness or hardness. We must also see, if we know the type of the rock, we can assess the brittleness or hardness of the rock. Next, during this investigation, we must see, do investigation by drilling. We must take the core samples by drilling and the drop down shaft. See, the ways we can take the samples, if one is core sample, we need the core sample. Another is the drop down shaft. By with the help of the drop down shaft, we can take the samples. These both are done by drilling process. Next is test pits. We must make the test pits only for only good for soft rocks. So this test pits which we make are only good for the soft rocks. Now the third one, for investigation purpose, we must take the seismic measurement, and seismic measurement we can be taken by with the help of seismic seismometers, and that seismometer will record the motion of the earth or subject rock, or the motion of the waves within the rock subject. Now how under rock handling, we have to handle rock under given four phases. First, in loosen, we have to loosen the rock by blasting or ripping apart the rock, the various techniques. Second, we have to load that ripped or blasted rock talus, the debris we left, with the help of shovel, and load onto the loader. Now we have to, next is to carry that rock debris, and that rock debris will be carried with the help of truck or wagon, and then we compact. We have to compact the debris to the desired place. So we can do with compacted the rollers, which compact, which have, there are basically two types of roller. One is vibratory roller and another is static roller. So we can take the help of those rollers and compact the given rock sample. Next is tunneling. While making a tunneling, we must see that tunneling in the earlier days used to mean with the help of drilling and blasting, but nowadays in the recent past we are using tunnel boring machines. A tunnel boring machine, usually we use one machine, and it is a big machine with diameter ranges from 1 meter to 19.25 meter. It has a rotating head with debris handling system. So the extreme tip, the face of the machine has a rotating head which suck the debris and suck into the and carry it to the backward end of the machine. The jumbo is a large mobile frame that can drill a complete rock face at once. So we have these features in the tunnel boring machine. That jumbo is of hydraulic jumbo, which is self-propelled machine with hydraulic arms with drilling. It helps the machine to move forward while drilling. Then within that machine, it is a set of different machines and equipments which we use while tunneling. So the face of the machine drill the bore the tunnel, which take the debris, suck the debris, and that debris, if it is a rock, it will be debris. If it is a soft solid, it will be a muck, and that muck will be carried to the mucking machine from the shovel used to load fractured rocks into the hauling unit. So with the help of the hauling units, within the boring machine, the muck is being served to the mucking machine, and that mucking machine will throw the muck behind of the machine. Now the percussion, another equipment which we use, which is enabled in the tunnel boring machine, is percussion. Percussion is a jackhammer, then drifters, wagon drill. These are the equipments which we use for drilling, which is inbuilt in the TBM, and we can use as a separate equipment also, while if you are not using TBM. Another equipment is track drill, which operates by hitting a bit which rotates between the gloves. So the bits are the tiny the rods which drills into the subject rock, and these are the bits. We name them as bit drill bits. And the third equipment for drilling is rotary drill, which has a diamond tip, and that diamond tip will cut the rock faces. Now the drill rate depends on rock hardness. So as we said earlier during the characteristics of rock, that the drill rate depends upon the rock hardness, which we must know the rock, the type of rock, and the hardness of the rock, drill type, drill energy, width type and the pressure which it will take to drill down. That all depends upon the type of rock which we are building, the subject rock. So we must be able to identify the rocks. Now the drill bits which we are seeing here, the drill bits are made up of tungsten, carbide, steel, and the steel which is used in drill connects drill bit to the percussion machine which actually helps in excavating the rock. The drill pipe connects the rotary bit to the machine. So this is the entire, this is how the drill machine is made, and that various equipments or various the parts of the drill machine. This is the diagram of the internal boring machine. This is the disc cutter, the face of the internal boring machine, and where the drill bits being attached that it drills forward. This is the machine's shield, and that machine contains the ring beam erector thrust cylinder which actually propels the TBM forward. Here we have installed segment which protects the upper face of the machine, as well it sets the upper face of the tunnel so that it should not fall on the machine. And that installed segment has probe drill. Now we have the operator cabin almost at the mid of the TBM, so operator can see how much boring is going on, the health maintenance of the machine as well. Now just above the operator's cabin we have TBM conveyor, the tunnel boring machine conveyor. And that conveyor actually helps to haul the debris, muck or whatever we are the debris we are getting, and to the mucking hammer, the end of the tunnel boring machine. So this is how tunnel boring machine looks and how it works. Now the drill patterns depends on the size of hole, depth, spacing, and amount of the explosive which we are using, and that explosive depends on the degree of the rock break desired. So at the end, everything which we drill or we excavate, everything depends on the rock characteristics, and that blast, the explosive which we use to blast the rock also depends on the rock, the type of rock and the hardness of the rock. The explosive which we use commonly for rock excavation is dynamite. Now the dynamite has been replaced by the ammonium nitrate in fuel oil or slurry. So this dynamite is being used, replaced by these three, because these three is better to handle than dynamite, and we can do the controlled excavation with this. Now the detonators, how we use the detonators. The detonators are electric blasting caps. It instantaneous or time delayed. It can be instantaneous or it can be time delayed. It ignite primers, usually placed at the bottom of the hole, and we can it can be a primer or prima. Or these are the detonator, the different things which we use, which detonator has. And this is how the detonator detonates the dynamite or ammonium nitrate or whatever we are using as explosive. Now, how much amount of explosive is required? The amount of explosive required to produce desired rock fracture equals to the powder factor. The powder, how much powder we are using, pounds. Then this is the amount. Then blast holes loaded with explosive, except for last several feet. So this is how how much hole we have made and all these things. Now, the last one is the stemming is placed on top of the explosive, which is essentially an inert material. So, this is how the detonators works and how much explosive is required for detonating excavation. The next, this is how all about the rock excavation. It is a brief as per the syllabus of the Indian geology. We can study that in, during to the next chapter. Thank you.